Once upon a time, in the heart of Cape Town, there stood an ancient mill, Mostert’Mill, built in 1796. This old centennial watched over the land for centuries, its sails turning, bringing life to grains and wheat, transforming them into flour that would nourish generations. But one dark day, a fierce ravaged this beloved monument, leaving it a charred ruin, seemingly lost to history. Yet from the ashes the mill rose like a phoenix, lovingly restored by the hands and hearts of Andy, John, Michael, Jake, and countless helpers and donors who breathed life back into the walls. Together, they transformed vision into reality, each name a part of the foundation, every effort woven into the mill's rebirth. "And here we go," that joint effort. The mill is now fully operational. What visionaries. For once believed dead mill to produce flour, and with a simple addition of water, salt, and a touch of love, become something alive again. This is the essence of revival, a story of transformation and heart. Thank you, Marianne, for sharing your vision and bring us all here to that amazing place. You have woven together a community of creators and protectors. And we all came here not just to consume, but to renew, preserve, and breathe life into what once seemed lost.
Yep, then we work with a heritage vineyards in Wellington. We're working with endangered wild dogs and also endangered vines, old vines. And this project has kind of evened that out so people appreciate the quality. And it's our 2018 vintage, so this is
the bread, wine, and cheese tasting shared in the company of wonderful friends on this glorious summer days made this moment unforgettable, a day to cherish for years to come. Thank you, Marianne. Thank you.
The volunteers, like Andy, Michael, and Jake, thank you so much for being here. Hosting us today.
Thank you.
IWC spouses that are here today as well, and we love them coming along too. Expert partnership. This team has taken pride in their work, and it shows. And it is a joy, John, to see Mostert’s Mill literally having risen from the ashes.
Thank you.
Your enthusiasm and your passion for the mill. I spoke about the mill being a beacon of hope, which I really believe that it is. It is a symbol of the past. It is also a symbol of the future, because it shows what can be done when people believe in something, have a common goal, and then go about making their dream come true. And when what you, John, and your team at Mostert’s Mill have proved is that it can be done, even at great odds, gives us hope. Hope that the same can be done again in this beautiful country of ours, that we can rise once again and one day look back with pride at what we have all achieved for the greater good. So we all need to look at you and follow the example that you have set.
I just want to say on behalf of the friends of Mostert’Mill, it's a great pleasure to host you at the mill today. And I want you to go out there and tell everybody about Mostert’Mill. Tell them about the third Saturday of every month. And I want to thank Marianne. I want to thank you for the donation. Every cent of this will be put to good value. I want to thank Jutta for doing such a fabulous job with the bread. And not only, not really, for everybody who's made today a success, thank you very much. It's been a great pleasure hosting you guys here.
And he said, well, it's not quite ready. He says, I'm still busy with the floor. And I said, well, that's not a problem. We'll come anywhere. When we came here, we heard about the prospect of meal being ground at the mill. Something we didn't realize at the time would ever be possible. So one thing led to another. And on that day, Inga and Jutta spoke about baking bread with the meal from the mill. And Emma was here and she said, if we return, I'm going to bring along some wine. I said, we've got a party in the making. So here we are today. These three ladies have kept their word. They stepped up to make this event possible. I call these two sisters the can-do team. They don't shy away from trying something new. Instead, they look at the situation as an opportunity and say, how can we make it happen? They are born entrepreneurs, so talented and full of ideas. Each sourdough bread baked for today was a work of art. You must agree.
Yes.
And it tasted. Emma, we're so grateful to you for your generous offer to sponsor the wine for today. As with these two girls, I couldn't have done it without you. And thank you, all of us. So, as a founder of Painted Wolf Wines, you made a decision to get involved with the conservation of wild dogs in Africa. They are an endangered species, and for each bottle of wine that you sell, you give a 4% donation to those organizations that you support to save the wild dogs.
Opportunity to be here and have such a wonderful experience, not only for us but for all of you. I think it was something different.
Thank you very much for making this event happen.
Thank you so much. Can I make liquor out of it?
Thank you.
Thank you.